Howdy folks, George Shively with you here from Chestertown, Maryland. We are on board a 1996 Sea Ray 400 Express Cruiser. As you can see, the helm is a bit taken apart. We just got here from Cleveland, and we are going to make this look a whole lot better than it does now. If you can look at this helm, this has been redone. This is just wood. And that's really not exactly quite right. You might call me a little greenhorn here, but I've never seen a 400 EC powered with the Yanmar, so I'm having a feeling that this boat was probably repowered at some point. But regardless, we have a new panel that goes in the lower area here. We have a new panel that goes in this area. And we have a new panel that goes here where the radar used to be. So we're going to get going here and start doing what we need to do, and we'll step back and show you the arch here real quick to give you an idea what that looks like. And we've got the old Raytheon radome up there. That's going to be gone. The GPS antenna is going to be gone, and the Sea Watch antenna is going to be gone. All of that will be cleaned up. We're going to replace the TV antenna and the radar. Of course, the GPS antenna, we'll go ahead and put that inside the helm so that we keep the top of the arch looking spiffy. So, just wanted to show you kind of a look here before we get going, and then we'll drop in as we move along on the project. I appreciate you tuning in. Thank you very much. Stay tuned. Hey folks, George Shively back with you here on the 400 Express Cruiser. Just want to show you what we did here to replace the antennas on top of the arch. Cleaned it off. The nav light, as you remember, used to be on the port side. Radar was in the center, and then there was a GPS antenna and an older TV antenna on the starboard side. I've cleaned that up a little bit, put a mount on the radar, which just gives it a sharper look, and then the nav light gives us the ability to have the nav light coming off the radar. And then we went ahead and replaced the TV antenna with a modern one, a little sharper, and really gave us the opportunity to get all the jitty moss off the top of the arch. So, coming inside here, we've done quite a bit in the helm, if you remember what it used to look like. This is what it looks like now. Garmin 5212 up here in the corner. We went ahead and remounted the VHF radio because we're going to keep that. So we've got the West Marine radio that was on the boat. We put a GMI 20 in. Of course, the panel was custom etched and modified because it used to say Mercruisers. I do believe this boat's been repowered now with the Yanmars. So it says appropriately Yanmar 350. So that is technically correct. Went ahead and made the new panel and took out all the old gauges and put in the, we'll save the gauges, of course, and put in the new fascia panel there. And then, of course, the Garmin 5212 here at the top with a new fascia ring around it. By eliminating the trim vinyl ring around it, we're able to put in a 12-inch screen as compared to something appreciably smaller. So just wanted to give you a show here of what it looks like now that we're done, and came out looking real nice. The radio before actually was just sitting inside of an old ICOM VHF radio slot. So probably the ICOM radio died on them, and they just went ahead and took the West Marine and slid it in the spot. Well, we got rid of that old mount, which really doesn't have any purpose, and properly flush mounted the West Marine radio, so it looks a little nicer. And again, just cleaned up the helm. So just kind of wanted to give you a shot here of what it looks like now that we're done. As always, South Shore Marine Electronics. My name is George Shively. You can reach us at 216-407-6553. And our email address, southshoremarineelectronics@oh.rr.com. And as I said, we are on location in Chestertown, Maryland. So if you'd like us to come to your boat, just drop us a line or send us a message. Thanks very much for watching.